All right, welcome back to our channel, guys. I'm Rod. I'm here with my dad,
Rod Senior,
and we are
Bridging the Gap.
Yes, sir. The boys is back with another fire reaction video for you. All right, yeah. So today we're going to be listening to the Slim Shady LP by Eminem. What do you think about that one, Dad?
Sounds good. I've been wanting to hear some more Eminem.
Yeah, a lot of people like our Eminem videos. The Eminem Show is our most highly viewed video. The Eminem fans are still talking shit to me.
About what?
Oh, just some of my comments that I made during the Eminem Show. But it's all good. We appreciate everybody. Hey, if you like our videos, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Also, drop a comment. Let us know what else we should react to today in our videos. And make sure you turn on post notifications so you're notified every single time we drop a new video. If you like our videos, you want to see the uncut, unedited versions, check out the Patreon. Links in the description. Shout out also to our sponsor, The Coldest Water. We have the coldest water bottle. If you want to keep your water the coldest it can be, put it in one of their water bottles. It's got a big rubber grip, a nice handle, a spout. You can take it anywhere, and it's going to keep your water cold up to 36 hours. So shout out to The Coldest Water. We appreciate you. Thank you so much. You can get a discount from one of their water bottles with a link in our description. But yeah, today, Dad, we're going to listen to the Slim Shady LP. It is Eminem's second studio album. It was released February 23rd, 1999 by Aftermath Entertainment and Interscope Records. They recorded it in Michigan. This is after Eminem has been recruited by Dr. Dre and Jimmy Iovine.
Oh, okay.
And it's got production from Dre, the Bass Brothers, and Eminem himself. That's pretty much been the formula that they've used on all the other albums that we listen to. Mm-hmm. Some Dre, some M, and the Bass Brothers in there helping out. Yeah, so this is the other Eminem album that I like.
You in trouble now. You in trouble now.
I don't care. Say what they want. I like what I like. And I like this one.
They cop that shade.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, pardon the pun.
Ah, I see what you did there. The shade. Okay. So, yeah, here's Slim Shady. We'll start off with the first track. It is a public service announcement to let you know what we are about to get into. It's produced by Eminem and Jeff Bezos. Here we go.
And are not necessarily the views of anyone. However, the events and suggestions that appear on this album are not to be taken lightly. Children should not.
Oh my
Slim
God.
Shady is not responsible for your actions. Upon purchasing this album, you have agreed not to try this at home.
Dude, it's cray cray, man.
Anything else?
Yeah. Dude. Don't do drugs.
All right.
Children should not try this with laces in their shoes.
That's the public service announcement. Public service announcement. What do you think about
that? He spent some time in jail, I see. juvenile. All right. It was funny. It was funny. It catches your attention. So.
Okay.
I know it was going to be crazy anyway because it's Eminem, but I like it's kind of crazy.
Yeah. The next track is going to be the big single off of this album. It's called My Name Is. It's produced by Dr. Dre. I just saw this interview that said that I guess this is one of the first songs that they recorded together. Like Eminem had come to the studio to meet Dre, mm-hmm. and this is like one of the first songs that they recorded. Dre played his beat, and then like he took it home and wrote his verses, and then came back and recorded it, and that the rest was history.
Oh wow!
Yeah, so that's kind of cool to know.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, they just knocked it out the park. Like. As soon as they got it going. So, all right, yeah. So, this one's called My Name Is, produced by Dr. Dre. Here we go.
My name is. Do you like violence?
Yeah,
wanna
yeah,
see
yeah.
me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids?
Uh-huh.
Wanna copy me and do exactly like I did?
Yeah,
try
yeah.
sit and get fucked up worse than my life is? Cause I hung my original Ooh, self from the top bump with a belt. Yeah. Pissed well, off and ripped Pamela Lee's tits off and smacked her so hard I knocked her close back with like Chris Paul. I smoke a fat pound of grass and fall on my ass faster than a fat bitch who sat down too fast. My English
teacher wanted to flunk me in junior high. Thanks a lot. Next semester, I'll be 35. I smacked him in his face with an eraser. Chased him with a stapler. Stapled his nuts to a stack of paper. Walked in a strip club. Had my jacket zipped up. Blast the bartender. And stuck my dick in a tip cup. Damn. Extraterrestrial. Running over pedestrians. Stop the tape. This kid needs to be locked away.
Get him.
Dr. Dre, don't just stand there. Operate. I'm not ready to leave. It's too scary to die. I'll have to be carried inside the cemetery and buried alive. It's, how you gonna breastfeed me, mom? You ain't got no tits. I lay awake and strap myself in the bed with a bulletproof vest on and shoot myself in the head.
Bang!
I'm steaming mad. And by the way, when you see my dad,
yeah,
tell him that I slit his throat in this dream I had.
Hi. My name is what? My name is what? My name is.
You don't like nobody in your family, bro.
My name is what? My name is what? My name is
Slim Shady. All right, that is track number two. My name is. What did you think about that one, Dad?
I thought it was a good start off to the album, and as you know, it didn't surprise me since I've heard some Eminem now that he's just wacko crazy. But then I was thinking to myself, like on that last album he had, he was talking about Kim, and he did talk about his mom, but did he talk about his dad on that one too?
Yeah, he talked about his dad.
So he just don't like his whole family. He just don't.
Yeah,
like
he talks
anybody.
About his dad, like because his dad left.
Yeah.
When he was real young, so he really never had no relationship with
but
him.
But then he started talking about his mom, talking about, you know, she couldn't breastfeed him because she had no tits. And I'm like, dude, who are you? What?
My whole life I've been lied to. I just found out that my mom does more dope than I do.
Yeah. I was like, golly.
Yeah, that's why she sued him, and that's why in the other album he talks about how she sued him and he was going through all the stuff. She sued him off of that particular line.
Really?
I just found out my mom does more dope than I do. Yeah.
Oh, so, and he got, I hope, I mean, she didn't have a case, man.
I think they probably settled out of court or something like that. I don't remember what happened, but yeah, she sued him, and then he would rap about it in his later lyrics. Oh, so
it
was a public feud for a long time in the beginning of his career, for sure.
Wow.
What'd you think about the production on that Dr. Dre beat?
It sounded real good. I liked it. For some reason, though, I think he had that this particular lyrics and stuff, the words to this song. And for some reason, I feel like he had that this tucked in his back pocket and been holding on to it for a really long time. All he needed was the beats to go with it. You know, because it was something like he had on his mind for a really long time. You
yeah,
know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was a good song. Nice beat. Nice effects to that. Chicka, chicka, chicka. Yeah. All right.
Cool. All right. We'll go ahead and move into the next song. Next song is titled Guilty Conscious featuring Dr. Dre. You've actually heard this song. I played you this video one time. We were sitting here after we were done recording. But I don't know.
Guilty Conscious.
I don't know if you'll remember it, but this is Eminem and Dr. Dre on the production, as well as Eminem and Dr. Dre rapping on here. So it's a cool video to it. It'll probably come back to you once you start hearing the song.
Okay.
All right, here's Guilty Conscience.
Meet Eddie, 23 years old. Fed up with life and the way things are going, he decides to rob a liquor store. But on his way in, he has a sudden change of heart, and suddenly his conscience comes into play.
All right, stop. Now before you walk in the door of this liquor store and try to get money out the drawer, you better think of the consequence. I'm your motherfucking conscience.
That's nonsense. Go in, gap for the money, and run to one of your aunt's cribs and borrow a damn dress, the one of a brown wig. Telling you need a place to stay. You'll be safe for days if you shave your legs with Renee's razor blades.
Yeah, but if it all goes through like it's supposed to, the whole neighborhood knows you and they'll expose you.
I don't like your attitude.
Come on. Coming in for a minute.
Oh no.
Look, it's gonna be all right, right?
Meet Stan, 21 years old. After meeting a young...
Take advantage of her, that's not fair.
Yo, look at her bush, doesn't got hair? Uh-huh. Fuck this bitch right here on the spot bare. Till she passes out, she forgot how she got there.
Man, ain't you ever seen that one movie, Kids?
No, but I seen the porno with Son Nubian.
Shit, you wanna get hauled off to jail?
Man, fuck that, hit that shit raw dog and bail.
Damn,
Dude, crazy.
Meet Grady, a 29-year-old construction worker.
I like his narrative.
After coming home from a hard day's work, he walks in the door of his trailer park home.
Fox letting her throw, cut this bitch's head off.
Wait, what if there's an explanation for this shit?
What? She tripped, fell, landed on his dick?
All right, Shady, maybe he's right, Grady. But think about the baby before you get all crazy.
Okay, thought about it.
Shoot them both, Grady. Where's your gun at?
All right, that's guilty conscience.
I like those little stories, man. That was real unique.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I like the beat, and you could tell it's got that West Coast flavor. Dun 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 dun. Yeah, that's a nice sound. I mean, well, it ain't nice, but it's a good. It's I don't even know how to describe the damn song, man. I don't want to call it nice.
Yeah.
Because
it
ain't nice. But it's entertaining.
The concept is really like dope because they're telling, they got all these three scenarios. And then you got Dre and Em as being each character's conscience.
Right.
And it's like the devil on one shoulder and the angel on the other shoulder.
What I like when this last one, he said, oh, man, shoot them both.
Yeah. What's your gut at?
He said, yeah, what am I saying? Yeah. You're right. Yeah.
Yeah, and I think it's kind of like sparked off their relationship too, is like how Eminem kind of disses Dr. Dre.
He's like, Dr. Dre, you got, what did he say? Man, he had a line in there.
Mr. Dre, Mr. NWA, Mr. AK, coming straight out of Compton. Y'all better make way. Like, he's making, he's kind of like shooting at him, you know, a little bit.
He did shoot at him. But you know what?
It's all good fun, right?
Yeah, it's all fun. And I guess I'm surprised that they are collaborating and getting, you know, getting along so well.
Mm-hmm.
Because it seemed like, I don't know, in my mind, these East Coast, West Coast, they hated each other, you know. So, I mean, no matter what rap groups it's just, if you was from the East and I'm from the West, it just seemed like they automatically had an instant hatred for another. So this seems like, they kicked it pretty well together, you know?
Yeah, I think it was more so like Dre had already been like establishing the game, and he got wind of Eminem and he saw dollar signs and he went and grabbed him up as soon as he could.
Exactly.
And they got to work, and this is what came about.
Money.
Of it. So
get that money.
They wasn't thinking about no East Coast, West Coast on this one. But yeah, here we go. We'll go ahead and slide into the next track here. This is track number 4. It's called Brain Damage.
Brain damage. Yep. Absolutely.
And this one is produced by the Bass Brothers.
Maybe that should have been the title of the album. I'm brain damaged.
For sure. This one's a very, very interesting song here. Can't wait to hear what you think about it. Brain damage.
Scalpel.
Hair.
Sponge.
Hair.
Wait. He's convulsing. He's convulsing. We're gonna have to shock him.
Oh my God.
We're gonna have to shock him.
These are the results of 1,000 electric volts. A neck with bolts.
Nurse, we're losing him. Check the pulse.
A kid who refused to respect adults. Wore spectacles with tape frames and a freckled nose. A corny looking white boy, scrawny and always ornery. Cause I was always sick of brawny bullies picking on me. And I might snatch. One day just like that, I decided to strike back. And flattened every tire on the bike rack. My first day in junior high, this kid said,
it's you and I.
3 o'clock sharp, this afternoon you die. I looked at my watch, it was 1:20, my baby daughter Haley. I was harassed daily by this fat kid named D'Angelo Bailey.
An
eighth grader who acted obnoxious. Cause his father boxed us. So every day he shoved me in the lockers. One day he came in the bathroom while I was pissing and had me in the position to beat me into submission. Now, once and for good, I cocked the boomstick back and swung hard as I could and beat him over the head with it till I broke the wood.
Wow.
Knocked him down and stood on his chest with 1 foot. Made it home later that same day. Started reading a comic and suddenly everything became gray. I couldn't even see what I was trying to read. I went deaf and my left ear started to bleed. My mother started screaming, what are you on, drugs? Look at you, you're getting blood all over my rug. She beat me over the head with the remote control.
Wow.
Opened a hole and my whole brain fell out of my skull. I picked it up and screamed,
look, bitch, what have you done?
Oh my God, I'm sorry, son. Shut up, you cunt. I said, fuck it. Took it and stuck it back up in my head. Then I sewed it shut and put a couple of screws in my neck.
Brain damage. Brain
damage. All right, that's brain damage. What did you think about that one, Dad?
The only thing I can think is, man, this guy, when you hear him rap, he is so good. But on the other hand, you know, you look at the way his mind clicks, and I'm like, damn. I mean, like in this song right here, he couldn't even catch a break. I mean, damn, dude, was he beating him in the bathroom? The principal come in and started helping the dude whoop his ass. And then he gets home and mom cracks him over the head. Like, damn, you for real? And you kind of wonder to yourself, I wonder, is he making up this shit? Or is this like, did some of this stuff really happen to him?
Yeah, I definitely think he's exaggerating for sure. I don't know. But so, I mean, yeah, he was bullied. He was picked on, you know, and I think he kind of like, these are like thoughts in his head, like, oh, I wish I could just say this or do this or, you know.
Yeah.
yeah.
Oh, that man, that drum beat all through this song was killer, man.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I love the drums on that one. The Bass Brothers killed that. That boom, 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 boom. It sounded like somebody like banging on the door or something. Yeah, and that snare.
That snare, yep. Yeah, that was all good there. They killed it on that.
Cool, yeah. That's one of my favorite ones off of that. I just think it's a really entertaining song.
It is entertaining.
And you can just like picture all the scenes of what he's like describing.
I know, because that's what I was doing. I was thinking to myself, I was kind of visualizing all this stuff that was going on. I'm like, damn.
It's a tough day. The bully his wanted to beat him up.
Mama cracked him across the head, and his ears start bleeding. She talked about, y'all, you getting blood on the rug. Yeah. That's all she can think about. Blood on her rug, you know. Then she goes, I'm sorry, son. And then he started cussing her out. I'm like, man.
Yeah, that's super funny.
Yeah.
The next track is called Paul. It's a skit. This is a skit with him talking to his lawyer Paul Rosenberg, and he's always got these skits, you know, where he's talking to Paul and he's talking to his label person or whatever. So this is kind of like a carried on theme from the other album we listened to. Here's Paul. And then we'll probably just roll into the next track, which is If I Had. All right, here we go.
Hey, what's going on? This is Paul Rosenberg, your faithful attorney at law. Listen, I can explain. Give me a call.
Life by Marshall Mathers. Exactly to the damn ground. What are friends? Friends are people that you think are your friends, but they really your enemies. Identities and disguises to hide their true colors.
Wow.
So just when you think you're close enough to be brothers, they want to come, the day was always down.
That's singing in the life. Background.
I'm
nice.
Tired of life. I'm tired of backstabbing ass snakes with friendly grins. I'm tired of committing so many sins. Tired of always giving in while I'm on the john. If I had a million bucks, it wouldn't be enough, cause I'd still be out robbing armored trucks. If I had one wish, I would ask for a big enough ass for the whole world to care. They get to wear and play, you know what I'm saying? But hey, it's cool though. You know what I'm saying?
No, it ain't.
Just fed up. That's my word.
All right, man. That's If I Had. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Man, he just went. I was just listening to all the words and all the stuff he was talking about. He was tired of, and I was like, man, I was just feeling all of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I felt his anger. I felt his pain. I felt all of that. Yeah. And it was a good song, and it just had a like nice, steady beat, and that chick in the background was, If I Had a Million Dollars.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. That,
beautiful.
Yeah, it was.
No, that was beautiful. You nailed it. that's definitely one of those where he makes you feel him about
his frustrations. Man, I bet you a whole lot of people, when they heard this song, man, they was like, damn, that's me.
Yeah.
You know, they you know, some of the stuff he was describing it, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I liked the song. That was a real good song.
Cool.
All
right. So we'll
But
go
you
ahead.
Know what?
What?
I was just thinking about it. Like when his lawyer said, man, you need to tone it down.
Mm-hmm.
Why did he have to tone down his music, but he ain't telling, they ain't talking about them other rappers toning their stuff down? Because listen, when we listen to Biggie, Biggie was talking about all this horrific stuff he was going to do to kids and then throw them over a bridge in the water. Mm-hmm. Then nobody, I ain't heard no discussion about Biggie toning nothing down. But then he talks crap, and then they tell him he got to tone it down.
Mm-hmm. I think he was saying...
They didn't want to see no white boy talking crazy like that, but they're going to let the brothers slide when they talk crazy, basically to me, because they probably was thinking, June, he going to be like one of my Vanilla Ice kind of white boys or something like that. But then he turned out to be better than most rappers you hear, you know? I mean, so he was like, they always trying to diss him, but he be killing them.
Oh, that's a fact.
He be killing them. I tell you what, you don't get no rap battle with him. Nah, it is not. Now, some might challenge him. I mean, I guess, you know, the black rappers, it's some that are challenging. They'll step up to him. Mm-hmm. But, man, you better bring it.
Yeah.
You better bring it.
Yeah. There's really not too many people I could say could just, like, you know, stand toe-to-toe with Eminem. as far as lyrically.
Lyrically, dude.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm just like, I'd heard some of the best. Now you done turned me on to some of the best.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, I can't, in my mind, I haven't heard anybody could stand up to him.
Mm.
I mean, they might give it a valiant effort, but he will destroy you.
Yeah. I think like battle rapping and like beef, when you're in a beef with somebody, is definitely a different realm of the music than actually like making music.
I think he does it both ways, though.
Oh yeah, for sure. He did up to a point, in my opinion, but he still can really rap really good.
Man, look, I'd heard some of the other rappers, man, their music was good, and his is just as good or better.
Yeah,
I don't see anybody just overshadowing his music.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. His production and all of that.
No, we've listened to the best of his work for sure. There's other work that's less good than this.
Less good than of Eminem's.
Yeah, for sure.
So this is, you know,
we've listened to the best of his work, I believe. And we're listening to some of his.
So
best
the rest
work.
Of it's not that good. You don't think it's that good?
Some people like it.
I bet you I would like it. I don't know. I won't say that because I don't. I haven't heard it. So.
We'll give it but, a. I'm gonna give you, and I'm not gonna tell you.
He had to try real hard to fail to me. I mean, the guy is so super talented, man. He's just like Superman, right? He's a Superman rapper.
No, for sure. No, he's incredibly talented, and he's had a hell of a run. And even when he drops, like he dropped. That, you know, from the D to the LBC with Snoop Dogg, went crazy. You know, anything he drops, anytime, you know, it's gonna sell for sure. He's gonna do really big numbers. He's got an insanely large fan base and track record. You know, he's done it for a long time. This came out in '99. This is a breakout record.
9 years old.
9 years old. Yeah. I wasn't really listening to this probably till like. I don't know, like middle school.
Middle school?
Yeah, probably like middle school.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
You know you'd been on punishment for that.
Yeah, I was tired of listening to the Will Smith albums.
Your Xbox or something would have been took.
Well, at the computer, it was burning CDs.
I bet.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right, we'll go ahead and roll it to the next track. This one's titled 97 Bonnie and Clyde, produced by the Bass Brothers. So here we go.
The Bass Brothers.
Yeah.
They going to kill it with some drums, I see.
So if you remember when we listened to Marshall Mathers LP, there was a song called Kim.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the prequel to Kim. So...
I don't understand when you say prequel.
So Kim was a story. Mm-hmm. This is the story before Kim.
Before her. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I got you. I got you. Yeah.
So just a little context there. Okay. 97 Bonnie and Clyde. Mm-hmm.
just the two of us.
Baby, your daddy loves you. And I'll always be here for you. No matter what happens.
Through
all our time in this world, I would never give you up for nothing. Nobody in this world is ever gonna keep me from you.
Play by ourselves, can't we? Just the two of us. Just the two of us. And when we ride, just the two of us. Just the two of us. Just you and I, just the two of us. Just the two of us. And when we ride, just the two of us. Just the sun. And you don't want a brother, do ya? Maybe when you're old enough to understand a little better, I'll explain it to you. But for now, what you say, mama was real, real bad. Was being mean to dad and made him real, real mad. But I still feel sad that I put her on timeout. Sit back in the chair, honey, quit trying to climb out. I told you it's okay, hey, hey. When the baba, take a night night, nana boo, goo goo gaga, mama poo poo kaka, that'll change your daddy. Clean the baby up so. Just the two of us. Just you and I. Just the two of us.
Yeah.
Just the two of us. And when we ride, just the two of us. Sweepy to hear you screaming in the ear. That's why you can't get it away. But don't worry, daddy made a nice bed for mommy at the bottom of the lake. Here, you wanna help daddy tie a rope around this rock? We'll tie it to a footy, then we'll roll her off the dock. Ready now? Here we go, on the count of three.
Woo!
One, two, three. Whee! There goes mama splashing in the water. No more fighting with dad. No more restraining order. No more stepdad. No more new brother. Blow a kiss and bye-bye. Tell mama you love her. We'll go play in the sand, build a castle and junk. But first, just help dad with two more things out the trunk. Just the two of us.
Yeah, he put a harp in there. Did you hear that?
And when we ride,
you didn't hear that harp.
Just the two of us. Just the two of us. Just you and I. Just the two of us. Just the two of us.
Maybe he might do it again.
Me and you, baby. If you ever need anything, just ask.
He made it all beautiful.
Dada will be right there. Your dada loves you. I love you, baby.
All right, that's 97 Bonnie and Clyde.
He's crazy,
what you think about
man.
That one?
He's crazy. I keep saying it, man. Eminem, he's really crazy. So I was thinking about he does have a real daughter in real life.
Yeah.
And shoot, there was like, and you said this album was made in 99.
99, yeah.
So she must have been a real, she was a baby then, so mm-hmm. she's probably grown now.
Yeah.
And that was his only child.
Mm-hmm.
She cuckoo crazy like him though.
She seems pretty
like,
normal.
She seems normal.
I mean, as normal as you can be being Eminem's daughter, like one of the biggest artists of all time. Their daughter, like
why she doing TikTok just
and,
for the fun of it? I guess.
Yeah, I mean everybody does TikTok. She don't do nothing crazy on there. Okay. But I think that is interesting. That like yeah, I mean she is such a like big part of his career because he raps about her all the time. Like he always, like especially in the earlier stuff, you know, he was dissing the mom and you know, yeah, I don't know. That would be, I feel like that would make most people pretty weird.
Kim still around?
I don't know.
She did.
No, I don't think he really killed her.
I mean, I don't know. I thought maybe she might have ended up at some point in time just kind of disappearing that they never did know what happened.
Yeah, I don't really
something.
Know what's up with Kim.
Well, she might. Well, then
maybe she did disappear.
I was going to say.
I don't know if Eminem disappeared her, but.
Exactly.
Haven't seen or heard from her in a long time.
Where's Kim?
Well, I'm
Kim.
Pretty sure he probably got some.
Kim.
Got so much money, you know, he probably just paid her to just go somewhere and shut up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, would you. Yeah, that's a pretty
that
wild
beat,
story.
That
do you,
beat was. Doom, 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 that yeah. Make, that's ride music right there. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did you remember kind of the Kim song?
Yeah, I remember because the last time I think we listened to him, he had her in the back of the trunk because she was kicking and yelling and stuff.
Yeah.
And he was getting ready to drive off of the bridge with her.
Uh-huh.
And then another time he went over her house and some drama.
Okay, no. When she was in the girl that was kicking and screaming in the trunk, he drove off the bridge. That was Stan. And Stan drove off the bridge with his girlfriend in the trunk because he was trying to be like Eminem.
Oh, that's right. Cause Stan, okay, yeah. You're yeah, right, but right. Well, somebody was in prison. Was it Eminem or was it Stan? And Stan got out or what? Was it?
No,
I get it all mixed up.
Nobody was in prison. With
Kim, I thought he was writing Eminem and stuff.
Oh yeah. He was writing them because he was just a fan. He was writing them from home.
I thought he was writing them from
but
prison.
But he was writing them, yeah. Mm-hmm. But yeah, Kim was like the continuation of this song. So okay. He kind of goes into what Kim did and why he was hurt and all of that stuff. But this is just like the prequel, him just putting her in the trunk, driving to the ocean. And,
right. It's tripping, man. He said, mommy just wants to see how long she can float. Don't worry about that little scratch on her throat.
Man, that's crazy. And to make that song like a song
he made
directly to your daughter, like that is
that's
crazy.
Why I asked about the daughter, man. Oh, my I was just like, God. Damn. I know she didn't heard all of this
she
music.
She had to, yeah, for sure. I wonder
what
that's like.
She was in the studio
like.
Sometime when he
I
was
wonder
making
that, what
that
that's
music.
like.
Oh,
that's
gosh.
Crazy. Because, like, you know, people's parents fight. But
lots
like,
of therapy, man.
God, yeah.
She like, had to.
For the whole world knows you're...
he needs lots of therapy.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, it was a good song. I like the beat, too. That beat was just like boom, 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 boom.
Yeah, that's
you
cool.
know, now all the rap music I heard, it's got, you know, that good beat like I like it. I mean, you know, but that right there is my kind of stuff.
Yeah. All right, cool. So we'll roll into the next track. It's another skit. This is called BITCH.
I love these skits.
Yeah.
That's the fun part about it, listening to this album, is all the skits. You know, I like that because. I don't know. Just makes it entertaining. It's
yeah, no, it definitely. And they like these older albums. They really prioritize the skit. Like it was part of like it would help tell the story of the album and stuff. I think skits are kind of played out now. Like people,
man, they
really
should bring skits
them.
Back, man.
If they did it in a good way,
yeah. Well, you have to do it in a good way to make it fit this time right now.
Yeah.
But it's not really that far long ago that they were doing the skits. I mean,
feel like Kendrick kind of incorporated a. Kind of the
yeah,
skits
he did. I remember
in his newer album. He definitely did it in his the first album we listened to, the Good Kid, Mad City. That was full of skits.
Mm-hmm.
But even in his more recent one, you know, he had the tapping and the Eckhart Tolle like quotes and stuff.
Yeah,
but yeah, I get what you mean. Yeah, they bring skits back, rappers. Only if you rap good and your skits are good though.
Yeah, because
if it's trash, then don't bring skits back. All right, here's Bitch skit, Eminem and Zoe Winkler.
Justin, it's Zoe. Kelly did not have me now nauseous and I can't eat lunch. Goodbye.
Damn.
Okay. So, that's some random girl showing her distaste in Eminem's music.
She says she can't even eat her lunch.
And then it rolls right into Role Model, track number 9. And this is produced by Dr. Dre and Mailman. And here we go.
She should have hit pause, and then she could have ate her lunch.
Here we go, Role Model.
Disgusting.
Okay, I'm going to attempt to drown myself. You can try this at home. You can be just like me.
Oh, my goodness. I know he got in trouble for that. That snare and that bass.
Mic check, 1, 2. We record? I'm cancerous, so when I dance, you wouldn't want to answer this. If you responded back with a battle rap, you wrote for
go
cannabis.
Go ahead.
I strangle you to death, and I choke you again. And break your fucking legs, see your bones poke through your skin.
I love when
you beat with me, I'ma even the score equally. Take you on Jerry Springer and beat your ass legally. I get too blunted off a funny homegrown. Cause when I smoke out, I hit the trees harder than Sonny Bono.
Oh, no.
So if I said I never did drugs, that would mean to jump behind the wheel like it was still legal.
Nice.
I'm dumb enough to walk in a store and steal. So I'm dumb
like
enough to ask for a date with Lauryn Hill. Some people only see that I'm white, ignoring skill. Cause I stand out like a green hat with an orange bill. But I don't get pissed, y'all don't even see through the mist. How the fuck can I be white? I don't even exist. I get a clean shave, bathe, go to a rave, die from an jump behind the door, put the orgy on hold, kill them both and smear blood in a white Bronco.
My
mind won't
club,
work
man.
If my spine don't jerk. I slap girl out of his rhinestone shirt. I'm not a player, just an
nobody's jamming this in the
yeah, they jamming.
Give me a clue.
I'm running out the morgue with your dead grand on the scorch to throw it on your porch. Jumped in a chicken hawk cartoon with a cake horn. And beat a foghorn leg horn with an egg horn.
You be like, oh my God, he did it.
With the formative traits of premature birth of a four-minute slave. Mother,
gonna be
are you there?
Hoes
I love you.
Cool.
I never meant to hit you over the head with that shovel.
You be like,
someone please explain to my brain that I just suffered the main vein with a chainsaw and I'm in pain. I just like me. I've been with 10 women who got HIV. Now don't you wanna grow up to be just like me? I've got genital warts and it burns when I pee.
Oh,
don't you
man.
Wanna grow up to be just like me? To be just like me.
I don't know about that tying up and jumping from a tree stuff.
Ouch. All right, that is Role Model. What do you think about that one, Dad?
I think I was just thinking about my club. I was like, shoot. I had that playing like, you know, like outside my club. It had some really nice quality speakers and it had that playing kind of low at that jam right there because my DJ be playing that right there.
Mm-hmm.
And then the lines be like, and everybody be out in the line while they waiting to get in the club. They be, yeah, let us in, let us in. Oh, yeah.
That's not going to be
that'll
a line.
Work.
Okay, there is going to be a line of people if you're playing Eminem at your club, but not... Not the type of people I want to go to the club.
Oh, you'll be the first one in line.
I promise you I'm not pulling up.
I'll be like, Ron, I got you the VIP room.
No. Oh, God. I got to just imagine this VIP. Oh, no.
It's going to be nice,
get
man.
Me out of here.
It's going to be nice. I'm telling you, it's going to be upscale, man. I'm telling you, but it'll just be
God.
Rocking. That's all.
No.
Yeah.
Sorry, I got plans.
Calling all your boys. Come on, my dad got it hooked up with the VIP.
My God. Now they don't even want to be my friend anymore.
He'll be like, I'll be right over, Rod.
So, no, that was just Eminem kind of just talking his crazy stuff. He was just saying crazy random things and telling people that he. Well, and this is kind of like something he covers too on his other albums. Like, yo, I'm not a role model. Like, you know,
right.
Parent your children, people. Like, don't look up to me. I'm just saying crazy stuff. I'm rhyming crazy stuff on beats. Like, yeah, he says crazy
he
stuff.
He talk about jumping in a damn cartoon and shit with the, what's the name of that big old chicken?
No, Foghorn Leghorn. Yeah.
I said, dude, he must have been real high. He must have been on some shrooms.
I'm running out the morgue with your dead grandmother's corpse to throw it on your porch. Jumped in a chicken hawk cartoon with a cape on and beat up Foghorn Leghorn with an acorn. I'm about as normal as Norman Bates with a deformative traits.
Like, yo,
he was rhyming so good.
He's
oh
crazy.
My God.
He got
and it's just funny.
Lines.
It's just you can just picture everything he says. It's
he
just
got
crazy.
Mad lines, man. He's always got me in tears, dude.
Nah, he's hilarious. Hilarious. So the next track is another skit. It's called Lounge. And then it goes into the next track, which is titled My Fault, and that's produced by Eminem and the Bass Brothers. So we'll just go from the lounge into My Fault. Here we go.
For all the ladies out there.
Okay. I never meant to give you mushrooms, girl.
Romantic, right?
Yeah, it is.
I never meant to bring you to my world, but now you're sitting in the corner crying.
Got like
and now it's my fault, my fault. I never meant to give you mushrooms, girl. I never meant to bring you to my world, but now you're sitting in the corner crying. And now it's my fault, my fault.
I'm with well trying. This party is so drag.
Oh, dang.
I ain't mean for you to eat the whole bag.
Huh? I never meant to give you. Girl, I never meant to bring you to my world, but now you're sitting in the corner crying, and now it's my
dad's mouth. That ain't no reason to start wigging and spaz out. She said, help me, I think I'm having a never seen no one eat as many shrooms as you ate.
I never meant to give you mushrooms, girl.
What? Can you,
I
never meant can to you bring you to my shrooms? World.
No.
But now you're sitting in the corner crying. And
just
now
having
it's
a bad
my fault.
Yeah.
It
was an accident.
I never meant to give you mushrooms,
yeah.
girl. I never meant to bring you to my world. But now you're sitting in
balls, drinking Lysol.
She's gonna die, dude.
I know, and it's my fault.
I never meant to give you mushrooms, girl. I never meant to bring you to my world.
God. Damn, Susan. 22 caps.
That's my fault. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
It was funny. I did that that beat though. I've heard that beat before. It sounds so familiar. I just can't think of where I heard it from. The song that I could equate to that beat, to that song. I don't know what it was, but it'll come to me probably in a day or two. I don't know. Good song. It was like I said, entertaining, funny. Susan ate 22 caps. He only had three. And Dave's trying to take a dump. And he's asking Dave through the door, I guess. Hey, Dave, how long does this last? So they seem to think that she can die. And that was my question to you.
Nah, she ain't going to die.
She just thinks she's going to die.
Yeah, and she's probably like,
passed out,
and
something.
She's freaking them out too. So they're like, "Oh my God, she's gonna die!" But she ain't gonna die.
She gonna die. Okay.
Yeah, she's all right.
All right,
Susan. I'm sure Susan's fine.
Susan
just had a bad trip.
Cut their hair off.
Yeah, that's just fun. I like these fun songs, like where he's just like making fun of a situation. It sounds like it could probably be some truth to it, and you know, he's just kind of putting his Eminem spin on it.
I'm pretty sure he's been in some very, very wild predicaments and experiences. I can almost, man, if I had to put some money on it, I bet you this to some degree did happen.
Yeah, for sure. And Eminem, yeah, he's like, he talks about it a lot in his later music too. Like this part of his career, he was very, very messed up on all kind of drugs. He was taking pills. He was like drinking heavy and all kind of stuff. He's like definitely in the drug scene. So I'm sure he's seen all kind of crazy stuff.
Eminem, how old is he right now? Is he pushing 50?
Right now, I don't know. Let's see. Eminem, age. He's 49 years old.
Dang.
Yeah, coming up on 50.
I wonder, has he mellowed out any?
He went through a whole, time where he got clean, and then he relapsed.
Mm-hmm.
It's fun. It's one of his album names, and then he got clean again, and so apparently he's clean and he's good now. But yeah, during this time where he's to some people made like his best music was when he was super high.
I wonder where he resides at now. You know, where he what part of the country did he choose to settle down in? It's kind of interesting because he's from Detroit, obviously, and as he got wealthy, California.
Probably L.A. He's got a house in Michigan.
He still lives
in Michigan.
Kept one there, or that's his main
residence?
He's got
two Michigan. He's got two Michigan estates.
Mm.
Oh, he doesn't live in L.A. Yeah, actually, now that I think about it, yeah, Eminem doesn't seem like a guy that would move to L.A.
Yeah,
because he. It's like all against all that kind of industry being fake all the crap. But I was just thinking L.A. just because Dr. Dre and all of that. But he's Eminem, so now y'all can come out here and work with me.
Dude, he's got something against Sunshine. What the hell, dude?
Yeah.
Michigan. My bad. No disrespect to Michigan.
Shout out to Michigan.
Yeah.
So the next track is Ken Caniff Skit. And there was a Ken Caniff skit on the other.
I remember
album.
The name. Who was Ken?
Yeah,
who
Ken is Caniff he? Is the fictional gay character that Eminem made up to make fun of his ops.
His ops.
His people that he doesn't like.
Oh.
Okay, so here is Ken Caniff's skit, and then the next track after that, we'll break in between. Here we go. Ken Caniff skit.
Call this motherfucker. Oh, fuck yeah. Give him a piece of my mind. Hey there, cock boy. What are you
Connecticut, little bitch. Your mouth and not in your hand. Melt your ass, you little cock boy.
Yo, shut up, you little bitch.
Oh, you think I'm lying, huh?
Oh, he's dope.
All right, that is the Kim Kniff skit. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I'm telling you, man, just all the albums I listen to, you turn me on to. This one has made me laugh more than anyone of all of them, dude. Yeah. Very entertaining.
He said, melt in your mouth, not in your hand.
All right, I liked it.
All right. We'll go ahead and roll into the next track. It's track 13. It's called Come On Everybody. And
he just don't stop. He just keeps coming at you, man.
Yeah. Look at this artwork.
Pardon the pun on that one, too. He just keeps coming at you. All right, oh, I'll stop.
Look at his artwork. It's crazy.
Look at that.
That's nuts. This is featuring Dina Ray. This is produced by the Bass Brothers. Come On Everybody.
Dina Ray.
Track number 13. Dina Ray, she sings on a lot of Eminem's earlier stuff.
Oh, okay. She must have been that one on that first song.
She was.
That was okay.
Mm-hmm. And then you also heard her on the other Eminem album we listened to. All right, here we go. Track number 13. Come on, everybody.
Yo, mic check.
It's on.
Can you hear me?
Uh-oh.
All right, it goes like this.
Bussy.
My favorite color is red. Shit, I got four blown names and a sore throat. I got a wardrobe with an orange robe. I'm in the fourth beat. I'm freestyling every verse that I spit. Cause I don't even remember the words to my shit. I told the doc I need a change in sickness. I gave a girl herpes in exchange for syphilis. Put my LP on your Christmas gift list. You wanna get high here, bitch, just sniff this. Come on. Come on. I'm bored out of my gourd, so I took a hammer and nailed my foot to the floorboard of my Ford. Guess I'm just a sick, sick bastard. One sandwich short of a picnic basket. One Excedrin tablet short of a full medicine cabinet. Feel like my head has been shredded like lettuce and cabbage. And if you ever see a video for this shit, I'll probably be dressed up like a mummy with my boy. So I told him I was Mike D. It was like, gee, I don't know, Mike B. I told him, meet me at Kid Rock's next concert. I'll be standing by the Loch Ness Monster.
I'm gonna move out, then I did it to the weed house.
Smoked out till I started busting freestyles. Broke out subs. So just remember when I bomb your set. Yo, I only cuss to make your mom upset. Come on, everybody. 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 Come on, everybody.
He said, that song is jamming, dude.
All right, just so come on, everybody. What you think about that?
He was jamming. So he said, it's something about, don't get mad when I bomb your set. I only cuss because I won't make your mama. He just be saying all this stupid random stuff all the time, man. And it's so jam-packed with so much crazy stuff, he says. And just like, but it all be like,
it just rhymes so good.
Meshes
though, so
together.
It's really good.
Yeah, he be rolling with them rhymes, dude.
Yeah, I think I like that second verse the best. Like,
which one?
It says, I'm bored out of my gourd, so I took a hammer and nailed my foot to the floorboard of my Ford. Like, why? Why would you do that? Guess I'm just a sick bastard.
Yeah.
One sandwich short of a picnic basket. One extended tablet short of a full medicine cabinet. I feel like my head's been shredded like lettuce and cabbage. Yeah, he's dope. That's just good rapping. And it's just like, it's just funny, entertaining
that music,
stuff.
Man. It just be like, oh, you just want to just.
Yeah, that was a little groovy joint.
Yeah.
For sure. I like that one.
You trying to resist. I feel the resistance.
Oh, me?
Yeah.
I like this album.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Well, I played it. I like this album. This is, I'm telling you, the Slim Shady LP, the Marshall Mathers LP, and then some of the Eminem Show, I like. It's already out there. Yeah, like 300,000. I got so many. There's thousands of comments. You don't know what you're talking about. What? You skipped that song? Yes.
Man.
And I still. I love this question. They say, how did you skip such and such song? And I'd be like, with my index finger. All right, hold on
one second.
That's
a pretty good comment.
All right, so we will go ahead and roll into the next track. This is track number 14. This is titled Rock Bottom. This is produced by the Bass Brothers. And this is kind of one of those deeper cuts from Eminem.
All right.
Rock Bottom.
Hey, yo. This song is dedicated to all the happy people. All the happy people. Real nice lives. Watching ballers while they flossing and they pathfinders. These overnight stars becoming autograph signers. We all long to blow up and leave the past behind us. Along with the small fries and average half pinters. But player haters turning bitch like they have vaginas. Cause we see them dollar signs and let the cash blind us. Money or brain from dead end jobs with lame pay. And I'm tired of being hired and fired the same day. But fuck it, if you know the rules to the gameplay. Cause when we die, we know we all going the same way. Cause it's cool to be the player, but it sucks to be the fan. When all you need is marks to be the man, plus the luxury sedan. Bottom.
All right, that's Rock Bottom. What'd you think about that one?
That's a good song. It's like, eerie kind of depression kind of, I don't know, feel to it.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just talking about how it feels to be rock bottom when all you lucky people out there that just, you know, probably was born with a silver spoon in your mouth. He's just trying to explain to them how his life is, mm-hmm. I guess. So it was a decent song. It wasn't one of my favorites, but it was definitely not a song I did not like.
Yeah,
it's just a different tone, a different pace, different style, I guess, so to speak. Good lyrics again. He's always got good lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
The rhyme is crazy, and the flow was good. So yeah, it's a good song.
Cool.
Did you like that song?
Yeah, that was a like okay song. It's not like my favorite off of this, but this is a lot of people's favorite song off of this album. This is like one of the more popular songs off of this album, and just people that connect with the message and can feel his pain and his depression and anger and stress about just being broke and trying to raise his daughter and trying to, you know, make his life better. You know, he was frustrated, you can tell.
Yeah, I could see why a lot of people could. You know, when you listen to the words, you know, I see where a lot of people could attach themselves to this song, you know. So I could see it being a lot of people's favorite.
Yeah, and then also I'm reading this little excerpt here. This is one of the only two tracks on the Slim Shady LP, the other being If I Had, that is not from the Slim Shady persona's perspective.
Oh, okay.
So this is actually from Marshall Mathers. This is from, this is him straight up rapping. Mm. And then also, if I had $1 million, that's another one where it's like straight from his perspective. All these other crazy, wild stuff from Slim Shady.
Ego,
his alter ego, Slim Shady. Okay. So I think that's an interesting little piece of information. All right, we'll go ahead and roll into the next song. This is another one of the big singles. I think this is the first single that came off of this album.
Uh-huh.
This is titled Just Don't Give a F. And this is produced by the Bass Brothers and Eminem.
Mm-hmm.
And
I know he gonna get wild on this one.
Yeah. This is Eminem, Just Don't Give a F. Mm. Here we go.
Whoa! I get your hands in the air and get the clapping of them and like back and forth because this is what you thought it was.
Name is Marshall Mathers. I'm an alcoholic.
I'm Marshall.
I have a disease and I don't know what to call it. Better hide your wallet because I'm coming up quick to strip your cash. Bought a ticket to your concert to come and whip your ass. Bitch, I'm coming out swinging so fast that it'll make your eyes spin. You getting knocked the fuck out like Mike Tyson. The proof is in the pudding. The stats is Sean Holtman. I'll slit your motherfucking throat where up. Cause you finna get stuck, stolen, snuck. I just don't give a fuck. Somebody let me out this limousine. I'm a KHD.
like Rage Against the Machine. I'm convinced I'm a fiend, shooting up while this record is spinning. Clinically brain dead, I don't need a second opinion. I'm no comedian, too many mental problems got me snorting coke and smoking weed again. I'm going up over the curb, driving on the median. Finally made it home, but I don't got the key to get in. So when you see me on your block for two blocks, screaming fuck the world like Tupac, just don't give a fuck. Talking that shit behind my back, dirty Mac and telling your.
All right, that's Just Don't Give a F. What do you think about that one, Dad?
Interesting song. Dude, man, I just like his creativity. When I was listening to this song, though, I thought about all the descriptive words he uses. Mm. And I was thinking to myself, dude, if he was in an English class and he could actually use this language, he would probably get an A plus all the time, man, because he has such a variety of descriptive words.
For sure.
And they were in context. Mm-hmm. And, if it was permitted to this language, I mean, if I was his English teacher, I'd be like, damn, this dude is brilliant.
Yeah, yeah.
Give him an A plus on his paper.
For sure.
You know, for real, because there's a part where that little section right there.
Yeah.
And I was just like,
extortion, snorting, supporting abortion, pathological liar, blowing shit out of proportion, the loonies, zanies, spontaneous,
compulsive drinker, addict. Yeah, no man, I'm like,
yeah, yeah, it was going crazy.
Yeah, it was going crazy, but I'm telling you, man, it don't take you be able to use those words and put them all into context and the way he's describing things, man, it's not like. That's not of a stupid person, you know what I mean?
Right.
Sometimes you're not smart in school, you know, per se. Mm-hmm. But some people are just school bores them. Mm-hmm. They just don't want to do, straight up schoolwork. This right here, that's good. It's really good. So
yeah, he's an excellent writer, and I'm kind of glad that he didn't go the English the English major route. I think this worked out better for him.
Yeah.
We'll go ahead and roll to the next track. This is another skit. This is titled Soap. And
Soap.
Yeah, Soap. Oh, this has got us on the EP.
Is this a double album?
No, it's just a regular LP, but there was a previous EP before this came out, before he got like signed and stuff, and it was called the Slim Shady EP.
Mm-hmm.
And
EP,
yeah, it was like less songs. Mm-hmm. But then like he already had that, so when he got with Dre, he re-recorded some songs, recorded some new songs, threw some other stuff on here.
Oh, okay.
So this is the actual full length album.
Gotcha.
From kind of like the mixtape that he had before.
Ah.
So yeah, this is Soap. This is produced by the Bass Brothers.
Oh, it says
track
skit.
16. It's another skit. And then we're gonna roll right into As the World Turns.
Uh oh.
Skyler Montgomery.
I bet you never listened.
What do you want from
before,
me, Roger?
Ever.
No. I know it was
man.
You all along messing around.
That's
with
a good
my
period of time,
rock.
Man.
Wait a minute.
Out
you
on.
Hold
yeah.
it right there.
Yeah.
Me and that woman love each other. Love? What do you know of love?
Wow. That's one good soap right there.
Yes, man. Maybe true till I told this bitch in gym class that she was too fat to swim laps. She needed Slim Fast.
Who, me?
Yeah, bitch, you so big. You walked in the big panties and stepped on Jenny Craig. She picked me up to snap me like a skinny twig. Put me in a headlock, then I thought I'm a guinea pig. I felt the evilness and started transforming. It began storming. I heard a bunch of cheering fans swarming. Grabbed that bitch by her hair, drug her across the ground, and took her up to the highest diving board to toss her down.
Damn.
Sorry, coach, it's too late to tell me stop. When I drop this bitch face down and watch her belly flop. As the world turns. Prison escapers, so give me all your money.
Wow.
And don't try nothing funny, cause you know your stinking ass is too fat to try to outrun me. I went to grab my gun, that's when the rats put it on me. With an uppercut, hit me with a basket of laundry. I fell through the glass door, started causing a scene, slid across the floor, and flew right into a washing machine.
remember this magic trick. Go, go, gadget dick. Whip that shit out, and ain't no doubt about it. It hit the ground, caused an earthquake and power outage. I'm shouting now, bitch. Let's see who gets the best. Stuck that shit in crooked and fuck that fat slut to death. We all face small obstacles and challenges every day.
Small
that we must go through. These are the things that surround us through our atmosphere every day. Every single day, the world keeps turning. Keeps turning.
That last verse is so crazy. All right, that's As the World Turns. What do you think about that, Dad? Oh, my God.
Oh man, I love this guy, man. he hanging around at the laundromat where the white trash is. He's trying to rob them. He said, "Oh God, I treat you just a Faygo and a pizza," but he had no money.
Nah, I was about to roll this next blunt, but I ain't got no weed, no fillies, or no papers. Plus, I'm a rapist and a repeated prison escapist. So give me all your money and don't try nothing funny. No, you can't outrun me. Oh, my God. That is so funny.
Yeah,
that is hilarious. Hilarious story.
And then he ran up, followed all up into her house. He done ran in the bedroom and closed the door. He's standing out there with his gun, talking crazy to her. She said, "The door's open."
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
That sounds hilarious.
Yeah, it is.
I don't got too much on that. He's a wild dude. All right, next track is track 18, I'm Shady. This one is produced by Eminem and the Bass Brothers. Last one was produced by Eminem and the Bass Brothers as well. And, yeah, here is I'm Shady.
Yeah.
Who came through with two Glocks to terrorize your borough?
Huh?
Told you how to slap dips and murder your girl.
I did.
Gave you all the finger and told you to sit and twirl. Sold a billion tapes and still scream fuck the world.
Slim Shady.
So come and kill me while my name's hot and shoot me 25 times in the same spot.
I set you free, you know me.
Oh, he went a little super fly on
you.
I'm really calm and peaceful. I like birds, bees, I like people. I like funny things that make me happy and gleeful. Like when my teacher sucked my weenie in preschool. The airtight, but stab myself with a steel spike while I blow my brain out to see what it feels like. Cause this is how I am in real life. I don't wanna just die a normal death. I wanna be killed twice. And my baby mama's not dead. She's still alive and bitching. And I don't have herpes. My dick's just itching. It's not syphilis. And it's for being AIDS infested. I don't know yet. I'm too scared to get tested.
I got mushrooms. I got acid. I got tabs and aspirin tablets.
That's my name.
All right. That is I'm Shady. What did you think about that one?
So that right there was a good... a tribute to the song Pushin' Man.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that's a prime example of how you take a song and make it your own.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that was tight.
Yeah, I love that song.
Yeah,
that's one of my favorites. That beat is fire. Great rapping. Another Slim Shady song where he's just saying a bunch of crazy stuff.
I wondered if you switched the beat around, take his song and put it on the original Pusha Man and see how it sounded then, because the music was so much better on this one to me.
You think the music was better on this than Pusha Man?
Well, I don't know. Wait a minute. I'll take it back. Because that was Curtis Mayfield messing with right there.
Yeah,
so, But the beat was funky.
Yeah, it was a funky. Groovy beat. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like that beat a lot. All right. So we'll go ahead and roll into Bad Meets Evil. This is track number 19. This features Royce da 5'9". Oh, yeah, we got to change this. So this features Royce da 5'9". And he is a longtime collaborator with Eminem. They've rapped on a lot of stuff. They're good friends.
Mm.
Royce da 5'9" is also from Detroit. a really good rapper. I love Royce da 5'9". He's fire.
Okay.
This is produced by Eminem and the Bass Brothers. And yeah, Bad Meets Evil is like their... it started from this song, but they go on to like make a project titled Bad Meets Evil. And like, you know, one's bad, one's evil. And they just come on tracks and they just go crazy. So... I love Royce da 5'9".
Is he also? Oh, so Royce is gonna have some lines on this.
Yeah,
one.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, they're gonna go back and forth.
Oh, cool.
All right, here we go. Royce da 5'9", Bad Meets Evil. Here we go.
I reckon you ain't familiar with these here parts. You know, there's a story behind that there saloon. 20 years ago, man. Yeah. Two outlaws took this whole town over.
Air wrapped in a sheet. I'm not a real person, I'm a ghost trapped in a beat. I translate when my voice is read through a seismograph and the noise is spread. Picked up and transmitted through Royce's head. Trap him in his room, possess him in Royce's bed.
One track site without source. I buried the Christ corpse in my past life when the black knight mounted the white horse. And stay over word. It's like the Nazis in the nation collaborating, attempting to take over the earth.
Wow. Cause this is what happens when bad meets evil. And we hit the trees till we look like Vietnamese people. He's evil and I'm bad like Steve Siegel. Don't anybody can squeeze the range. Cold enough to make the seasons change in the freezing rain.
He's insane.
No, I'm not. I just want to shoot up and I'm pissed off because I can't find a decent
The disaster
game.
Of dreads. I'm bad enough to commit suicide and survive long enough to kill my soul
Roy.
After I'm dead. When in danger, it's funny.
I hear you,
actually, my flavor similar to a waiter because I serve any stranger with money. I spray 100 men until
I
they join chains while slipping bullets at point blank range like they was punches. Piss on the flag and burn it. Murder you, then come to your funeral service lobby and strangle your body to confirm it. Whipping human ass, throwing blows, cracking jaws. With my fist wrapped in gauze, dipped in glue and glass, I'm blazing MCs. At the same time, amazing MCs. Somehow, MCs ain't that eyebrow raising to me. From all angles of us, flash your mag loud enough to cast the avalanche and bust the volcanoes erupt.
Wow.
Hey, what's up?
I used to be a loudmouth. Remember me?
Uh-huh.
I'm the one who burned your house down.
Oh.
Well, I'm out now.
Shit.
And this time, I'm coming back to blow your house up. And I ain't gonna leave you with a window to jump out of. Give me two fat tabs and three shrooms, and you won't see me like fat people in steam.
Bye bye.
Bad meets evil.
Got a little
what?
Spanish flair to that guitar.
And so, that's the story of when bad meets evil. Two of the most wanted individuals in the county.
All right, that is Bad Meets Evil featuring Royce da 5'9". What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Well, I like the way they ended with those effects, and I like the whole song, man. It was very entertaining. And this Royce, what's his name, 59?
Royce da 5'9".
Oh, see, I'm always butchering up names. Royce da 5'9".
Yeah.
I can very well see why they get along very well.
Yeah,
I mean,
he
was mad, spitting those, man.
Yeah.
He was just killing it. He killed it. He was just like, every time Eminem did his thing, then he came back and just right there with him.
Yeah.
Right there with him.
For
you
sure.
know, dude.
Yeah, there's not a lot of people I feel like can hold their own when it comes to rapping with Eminem, and Royce da 5'9" is definitely one of those people. They've collabed a lot.
They probably do shrooms together. Sound like it.
I don't know if Royce is into that.
I don't know. The way Royce is talking, he might. I don't know. But yeah, your boy's got mad talent.
For sure.
I see why you like him. I would love to hear some more things from him.
Yeah, we're going to listen to, we'll do a Royce da 5'9" radio freestyle. He has a L.A. Leakers freestyle, so we'll check that out.
Oh, is that right?
Mm-hmm, for sure.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Yeah, we'll check that out.
All right.
So we'll go ahead and roll into the last track. This is track number 20. This is called Still Don't Give a F. So before he told us he just don't give a F.
He still
but
don't.
Now he still doesn't give a F.
Is this the last track?
Yeah, this is the last track. And this is Eminem and the Bass Brothers on the production. And yeah, this is the finale of the Slim Shady LP.
Okay.
Here we go.
A lot of people ask me, am I afraid of death? Hell yeah, I'm afraid of death. But fuck. I'm zoning off of one joint, stopping a limo, hopped in the window, shopping a demo at gunpoint. A lyricist without a clue, what year is this? Fuck a needle, here's a sword, body pierced with this.
living them up, never giving a fuck. Give me the keys, I'm drunk, and I've never driven the truck. But I smoke dope in the cab. I stab you with the sharpest knife I can grab. Come back the next week and reopen your scab. A killer instinct runs in the blood. Emptying full clips and burying guns in the mud. Slim Shady iron on, and the pants to max. Here, mama, try them on. I get a master tip with a mouth full of adjectives, a brain full of adverbs, and a box full of laxatives. Built an hospital accident. God help me before I commit some irresponsible acts again. For all the weed that I've smoked, yo, this blunt's for you. To all the people I've offended, yeah, fuck you too. To all the friends I used to have, rapping a motherfucking bomb across me. From the second I was born, my mama lost me. I'm a cross between Nance and Ishamanazi. I don't know why the fuck I'm here in the first place. My worst day on this earth was my first birthday. Retarded, what did that nurse say? Brain damage, fuck, I was born during the earthquake.
All right, that is Still Don't Give a F, track number 20 off of the Slim Shady LP. What did you think about that one, Dad?
Well, that's the perfect title to me to end in the album.
Yeah.
And just overall, this whole album, it was so entertaining because I like skits, and the skits were so funny and so well put together. And then the other part of it was that I like about this album was that, you know, when he was rapping and he says certain bars, and then he had these little voices answer back, and I like that.
Yeah.
So it made it that much more entertaining. So overall, man, I really, and you knew, well, you know, you could see I just enjoyed this album, man.
Yeah.
So it was good. It was good. I got turned on to a new guy, 59.
Royce the 5'9".
Royce, see? I keep jacking people's names.
You can call him 59. That's fine.
59. Like, okay, so we got a 59 and we got a 50.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so anyway, good. Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah, I knew you were going to enjoy that. So we've listened now to 3 Eminem albums. We kind of listened to them in a weird order.
Mm-hmm.
But this is his first big album,
mm-hmm.
Then it was the Marshall Mathers LP, and then it was the Eminem Show.
I can't even tell you which one I like the best. I mean, this one right here really had me going, though. So I guess if I was going to take those from the 3,
mm-hmm.
man, I don't know. I got to go back and listen to
them.
Yeah,
I feel like you need to listen to them.
This is fresh on me now.
Right,
so,
right.
You know, I'd have to go back and listen to them. But right now, I would say, you know, just from listening to this one, man, it was freaking.
You really liked this one.
Yeah, I liked it.
Cool. Well, hey, if you guys like this album and you like our videos, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Also, drop in the comments. Let us know what other album we should listen to. Let us know what your favorite track off of this album is. Turn on your post notifications so you're notified every single time we drop a new video. And if you like our videos, but you want to see them uncut, unedited, and you want to see all the exclusive content that we don't drop on YouTube, then consider subscribing to our Patreon. The link is in the description. Also, big shout out to the coldest water. We have the coldest water bottle in the world. It is so cold. It's going to keep your water cold for up to 36 hours. If you'd like to get one of these water bottles, they are fantastic, and the link is in the description. You can get 10% off by using the code BTG10 at checkout. Thank you again so much for watching our videos, guys, and we will see you next time. Bye.